you're probably thinking two things. One, who is this incredibly handsome man? And why does he have an extraordinarily large axe?
By the power of Grayskull,
I have the power! Now, why did I do that? You're gonna have to watch to find out.
Nothing left!
Oh, I found the chip.
Oh, shit, this might have been the real one. Oh, no. Oh, no. No, that's a fake. All right, we're good.
I'm surprised that's in one piece.
Yeah, me too. You can smell it. You can smell the destroyed game. Like, it's weird. I think I might have hit the battery. All right. Yeah, here we go.
Because you admitted that you were gonna get a pedicure and sell feet pics.
Sip my tea and look at the camera directly this entire time and say yes.
Yeah, no shame, no shame. If I had nicer feet, I'd be doing it all day, all day.
I would need a pedicure and I would need to shave them.
Yeah, no, I got hairy toes.
Maybe wax.
I got hobbit feet.
But yes.
But I have sensitive, like, soles in my feet. Like, it's different.
And I'm gonna keep staring and not blink.
Yeah, there you go. Alright, one.
Boosh! They could have known we were in the same day of the same video.
Shh! One.
I thought we changed outfits to rent this.
Three.
Oh, insane! And
boom! Dawn of the first day, 72 hours remain. We got it on. We got it at the same time, so now the moon's gonna fall. Alright, so anyway, Doug and Josh here.
Spin the screwdriver.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, nobody gets it!
Now we have to kiss.
Shit.
So, Doug and Josh.
Josh and Doug.
Doug and Josh. So, we did a video on how to tell counterfeit magic cards. If you haven't seen that yet, you should check it out. We'll probably have the link in the description or something. But today, we are going to go over something else that people in the nerd industry, I guess you could say, don't talk about a whole lot, which is how to spot fake video games. So we have a couple of Game Boy Advance cartridges here. You'll notice that they are both Pokemon Leaf Green version.
Amazing game.
Amazing game.
Killer Revolutionary game. First time, as every Pokemon game is.
One of these is real, and one of these is fake.
Now tell us which one!
Well, they can't yet.
So take a guess.
So, yeah, take your guess and comment right now.
This one's lighter than that one. This one's fake.
I'll give you about 15 seconds. Go ahead, go down. Comment which one you think is fake. The one in my right hand or the one in my left hand, or it'd be your left.
I think
my
the
right.
one in your left is fake.
Okay.
I think the darker green is more of a leafy green, and that's the real leaf green that Nintendo was going for.
We'll find out here in a second. Actually, this is the real game, and this is the fake game, and so here's a couple of ways that we can tell without even opening it. That's what this is for. This is a tri-wing screwdriver. I picked up an entire video game opening kit online for like $7 on Amazon.
Covered like all retro Nintendo systems.
Yeah, it's got two different screwdrivers for the hex nuts, or not the hex nuts, but the
hex screws,
hex bolts, whatever.
Yeah,
a tri-wing and a small Phillips head, as well as, you know, kind of like a spatula for cracking open the games that are, you know, sealed together by plastic. But, so anyway, before you even crack open a video game, one of these Game Boy cartridges, first thing you want to do is look into the port where the cartridge would enter the system. So, if you look on the inside there, I have the real one, Josh has the fake one. Hey Josh, when you look up there, what does it say inside of there?
Nintendo. AGB E0501.
Gotcha. So I have here copyright symbol 2001 Nintendo AGB EO2-20, which is the actual, what you'll notice is that there will always be a copyright in the year that the game comes out next to the Nintendo. Now, some people who make counterfeit games have gotten better at their stamping and have started stamping the dates. So, but this is just like a surefire red flag, just like the date's not on there, you're just like, oh, this is probably a fake.
Well, this is a really bad fake, so.
It is. So, going to the next things that you'll notice are on the real game, there is a number stamped into the foil sticker on the front of the game. This number is 13 on this one. I don't know if it's the same number on every Game Boy Advance game, but there will be a number stamped into the sticker on the front. You'll also notice that there is a different foil on the stickers, and that the color on the real one is more vibrant than the other. It is because whatever they do, they layer the color over the foil, and the counterfeiters layer it with the foil. So the color is foil, which gives it a darker appearance because of the reflective nature. If you compare the two, the letters that show the, you know, one of the coding of the games, is a much thinner font on the real one. It's much bolder on the fake. The actual font of Game Boy Advance that's stamped into
really
the plastic
on the fake.
Yeah, it's stamped in on the plastic. It's way thinner on the fake. And it doesn't follow the actual copywritten text for Game Boy Advance.
The font. Font's very
odd. You'll notice a similar difference in thickness of font and kerning on the back in the plastic stamping. And as far as, you know, without cracking the game open, just, you know, feel in hand, other than what I've just explained, there's no real way to... Yeah, there's no real way to feel a difference. However, looking at the plastics themselves, you'll notice that the original leaf green was way more matte, way more vibrant green, whereas the fake is a more emerald transparent.
Did you say the thing for the rating too, the ESRB rating?
Yeah, the ESRB thing, make sure you look at all the logos, make sure they're the right size and stuff like that. If you don't know off the top of your head what the sizing should look like, just Google what logo you're looking at and for a reference.
Another one that was very obvious for me here is on the fake, the official Nintendo seal is very, very off-center. You know, it's supposed to all be centered. On the real one, it's perfectly centered. On the fake one, the actual, how it says official, and then Nintendo is, like, in the oval there. That whole part is shifted to one side.
Yeah.
Compared to the real one, which is a big thing, too.
Yeah, it's completely off-center.
Yeah.
There. So, what we're going to do is we're going to use the Tri-Wing. I'm going to crack this sucker open and explain to you why this is bad. Another thing is right here, you can see the circuit board.
Another simple thing too, look at the wear on the games. These games are over a decade old, I think, in the case of this one. There's gonna be a lot of wear. I'm sure even on fakes, people will test them, so there's gonna be minimal wear, but like, you know, that game should have been put in and put out of the Game Boy probably 100 or more times.
I know, for
through
me,
the course of 10 years.
Alright, so...
Don't mix up the boards.
Automatically, you can tell that there is a distinct difference. And on the back as well, you will also notice a difference in the circuit boards. So, on the fake, there's a big, ugly solder spot. If you see this black gunk inside of a cartridge that you have opened, congratulations, you have a fake. The game companies did not use this particular stuff. If there is something like that on the circuit board, it will be a different color. If you're still not sure, there's pictures online that you can Google of the actual insides of the cartridge, because there are people who have posted pictures of the inside of fake games, either as a question, so on and so forth. So, big red flag. That's how you know it's a fake. If you look at the chipset on the two cartridges. One is significantly cleaner looking, smaller looking, more official looking, and they match manufacturers. On the fake, it's got corrosion on it because it's cheaply made. There's one just big ugly chip and one small chip, neither of which share a brand. you know, this one's Fujitsu, and this one doesn't even have a branding on it. It just says that it comes from China, which, obviously, it did not. So, on the inside, looking at the different chipsets, you can see also the circuit boards on the real game are much more complex, and you know, that denotes how much time they were taking into putting it. You know, it's just an easy way to tell. This one's just pretty run-of-the-mill, sloppy, and it almost seems like it is just connecting two pieces rather than several. So I mean, you know, going back to the dates being on the inside, you're able to see that on most cartridges, you know, without even opening it. Just looking through the port, you can just see copyright, the year came out, and then Nintendo. And if you look, the Nintendo's in the oval on the fake one, but on the real one, it's just the actual lettering. And that's another way to kind of tell them apart. So, hopefully this has been somewhat informative. You know, feel free to message us on Facebook if you have any questions, send us pictures, yada, yada, yada. But yeah, comment your favorite Pokemon game, and maybe I'll stop messing with my playmat. Comment with your favorite game, and you know, maybe I'll find a copy and I'll smash it to pieces. Stop it! This is a very nice playmat that I got for my birthday from our friend Rudy Dudane, who owns XVII Art and Design, who you should go check out on Facebook, shameless plug. Get out of here! Do it again. Come back next time where Josh is missing a hand. But anyway, 3436 Front Street, Port Jervis, New York, 12771. Haven for Heroes. Like, comment, subscribe. Yeah, exactly. Like, comment, subscribe. Fight me. Save me. We're out. Gotta screw this motherfudger back.
Who is this handsome man, and why is he overcompensating? Who is this handsome man, and does the carpet match the drapes? Who is this handsome man, and why is this axe pathetic next to his cock?